Friends, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Today I am going to take up a fifth semester subject, that is applied thermodynamics. Applied thermodynamics. Now already we have studied in fourth sem, we have studied basic thermodynamics, in which it has been basically what we have studied there is, I have already told you what is thermodynamics, what it means. It is a branch of engineering which studies the conversion of heat energy into mechanical energy or motion. Now, this is the continuation of that. Here, we start with the first chapter is, first unit is the properties of steam. Steam, you know, is a vapor. Steam is a vapor. So, first we have to learn in first unit, formation and properties of steam. Formation and properties of steam. We all know that steam is formed by heating water at constant pressure in a closed vessel, which is known as the steam generator or the boiler. So, steam is formed by heating water at constant pressure in a closed vessel called the boiler. That is how steam is formed. Now, we have to study what are the changes that are taking place here. See, we take the heat calculation, heat required to generate the steam, this calculation, for this we take water at 0 degree centigrade as the base. Water at 0 degree centigrade has no heat in it, or it has zero heat. So we start the heating, we start the calculation of finding the heat, quantity of heat required to generate steam with the base as this water at 0 degree centigrade. Now let us take 1 kg of water in a closed vessel, and suppose we are heating it at some constant pressure. What are the changes that we observe? We have taken 1 kg of water in a closed vessel. We have taken 1 kg water in a closed vessel and we are heating it at a constant pressure. The temperature of water is 0 degree centigrade and we have put a thermometer. That thermometer reads 0 degree centigrade. Now we start giving heat to it, heat to this water. As we start giving heat to this water, what we observe is there is a rise in temperature of water. The temperature of water steadily increases as the water absorbs the heat. Then a stage comes where the at one particular temperature, what happens is, even though we are continuously giving the heat, the water is absorbing the heat, you will find there is no increase in its temperature, and we see that the water has begun to boil. When the water begins to boil, or technically the correct word will be, as the water begins to evaporate, or that means nothing but the boiling starts. At that temperature, what happens is, even though we are giving the heat, even though water is absorbing the heat, there is no change in its temperature. The temperature remains constant. Right. Now, after that, this will be there for some time. Till what time? Till all the water in that vessel has completely converted into steam. There is no water particle left in the vessel. Till then, if you heat, then what happens is, after that point is reached, the temperature inside the vessel increases beyond that temperature. Now, then as we go on give heat, the temperature goes on steadily increasing. So this is what happens when 1 kg of water at 0 degree centigrade is taken in a vessel, closed vessel, and we start giving heat to it. Now, let us study it in detail. Now, the temperature at which the water begins to boil or begins to evaporate, this temperature is known as in common language, we call it as the boiling point of water, boiling point or boiling temperature of water. But technically, the same thing is called saturation temperature. So the first thing that we have to know about steam is the definition of saturation temperature. Now, it is defined as saturation temperature is defined as the temperature at which the water begins to boil or begins to evaporate. More suitable word will be evaporate. The water begins to evaporate when it is heated at some constant pressure. Now, this is denoted by Tsat. Normally, we denote it as Tsat, and it is expressed in degree centigrade. It is given in degree centigrade. Now, the value of this Tsat depends upon the pressure at which we are heating the water. Greater is the pressure, bigger is the pressure, more will be the saturation temperature, greater will be the saturation temperature. The saturation temperature of water depends upon the pressure at which we are heating, and it increases with pressure. Now, for any given pressure, we can get the value of saturation temperature from a table called the steam table. You get a table called the steam table, which is a mathematical table in which we have columns like this. You have the pressure column, the pressure base, the pressure in bars. The next will be the temperature. So the pressure goes on increasing from 0.001 bar, 0.002 bar, like this it goes on increasing. Here you will find the corresponding saturation temperature in degree centigrade. This, if you observe, as the pressure is increasing, the saturation temperature is also increasing. For any given pressure, we can pick up the value of saturation temperature from the steam table. This steam table is available in, I'll show you that. You get a table like this, steam table in SI units, steam table. In this, there are a few tables. The table which is useful to us is the steam table with pressure base, table number 2, I think. The pressure base, that is the first column here, will be pressure. You can observe here, as the pressure is increasing, the saturation temperature is also increasing. So it increases with increase in saturation temperature. It is given like this in the steam table. This table is called the steam table, and you are allowed to use this table in the examination. We for doing numericals, you can use these steam tables and Mollier chart. Right. The second definition which we get in steam is, in the properties of steam is, the definition of sensible heat. Sensible heat. Sensible heat, or it is also called as the total heat of water. Total heat of water. It is, its symbol is HF. Why it is HF? H is heat, quantity of heat. It is quantity of heat. Now, this is the heat absorbed by 1 kg water. When we are heating it at some constant pressure, it is absorbing the heat. How much heat it has taken when it is in liquid or fluid state? That's why it is denoted by F. Now, this is the heat taken by 1 kg water when it is heated at some constant pressure. To increase its temperature from 0 degree centigrade to saturation temperature corresponding to its pressure, the pressure at which we are heating the water. So, the quantity of heat taken by 1 kg water to increase its temperature from 0 degree centigrade to the saturation temperature corresponding to its pressure at which we are heating it, that is called as the sensible heat. It is denoted by HF. Its unit is kilojoule per kg. Its unit is kilojoule per kg, and this is also available in the steam table. This again depends upon the pressure. It depends upon the pressure. Now, here you will find one column HF. Now, this is the value. For any given pressure, again you can take the value of HF from this table, and you can observe in the steam table that as the pressure is increasing, the value of sensible heat also is increasing. So, this is also dependent on the pressure, and it increases as the pressure increases. Next, the third definition is what we call latent heat of evaporation. Now, why this is called as sensible heat is because we are able to sense its effect. That is, when the water is absorbing this heat, it is, its temperature is increasing, and we can sense it through our eyes. Eye is a sensory organ, you know. You are able to see the effect of that heat, so it is called as sensible heat. The third definition is that of latent heat, or it is also called as latent heat of evaporation. Now, this is the heat absorbed by 1 kg water when it is heated at constant pressure. When its temperature remains constant at saturation temperature, Now, this is the heat taken during the period of conversion from liquid state to gaseous state. So, its symbol will be HFG. H is heat, heat absorbed when it is converting from fluid state to gaseous state. So, during that period, this is the heat absorbed. It is also given in kilojoules per kg. Its unit is kilojoule per kg. And it also depends upon the pressure. But this decreases, the value of latent heat decreases as the pressure increases. You can see from the steam table, again, after this, this is P. You have somewhere here HF. Now, after HF, immediately after HF, you have HFG. You can see from the steam table, whereas the saturation temperature is increasing with increase in pressure, sensible heat is increasing with increase in pressure, but the value of latent heat keeps on decreasing as this pressure increases. Now finally, what happens is the value of HFG becomes 0 kilojoules per kg, zero, it becomes zero. Now the pressure at which the value of latent heat becomes zero is around 221.6 bar, and this is around 374 degrees centigrade. The saturation temperature corresponding to this is 374 degrees centigrade. Now this pressure at which the latent heat becomes zero is called the critical pressure. It is called the critical pressure of steam. Critical pressure of steam, and this temperature 374 point something, that is called the critical temperature of steam. So they can ask you to define this. So what is meant by critical pressure and what is meant by critical temperature? It is nothing but the pressure at which the latent heat of steam becomes zero is called the critical pressure, and the saturation temperature corresponding to this pressure is what you call the critical temperature. Now, the steam table will not go beyond this. This is the last point. The latent heat becomes zero, it stops here. This table stops here. Now, we cannot generate steam at a pressure higher than this pressure. Higher than 221.6 bar, we cannot generate steam. And we don't require steam of that pressure also. The highest pressure steam that we require is in a thermal power station, where we use the steam to run the turbines, where it will be around 170, 160, 170 bar only. It will not be more than that. In the where we are in a thermal power station, it may be around 170 bar. The pressure of steam we are using is around 170 bar. We don't require this pressure steam anywhere practically, and we cannot generate this also. Practically, it cannot be generated. This means the latent heat becomes zero means if you have taken 1 kg water in a vessel, the water instantly gets converted from liquid state to gaseous state. Such a thing will not happen practically. That cannot happen practically. We cannot generate steam of this pressure, and we don't require that pressure steam also in any industry. Now this is in the power station, thermal power station only, we require the pressure of very great pressure, and that will be around 160-170 bar, not more than that. So this is called as the latent heat of evaporation. Next comes the heat of superheat. Third one is the heat of superheat. Now this is the heat absorbed by 1 kg steam. Once we give this latent heat, once we give sensible heat, the temperature of water has increased from 0 degree centigrade to saturation temperature. Then we are giving this heat at saturation temperature. Now when we are giving this heat, the water is getting evaporated into the gaseous state, and once we have given all the latent heat, it has completely got converted into steam. There is no moisture, there is no water particle left in that. Now the heat which is given after this latent heat has been absorbed, now that is called as the heat of superheat. When we are giving this heat, the temperature of steam increases beyond the saturation temperature corresponding to its pressure, and the steam that we get here is known as the superheated steam. Now this heat of superheat will not be given, you cannot get from the steam table, because here no standard is there. you can give any amount of heat. You can increase the temperature beyond saturation temperature to any extent we want. Now the temperature of steam, superheated steam, it is given as T soup. Now this heat of superheat has to be calculated. Heat of superheat will be equal to Cp into T soup minus T sat, so many kilojoules per kg. This is called heat of superheat. Heat of superheat. Here Cp stands for specific heat of superheated steam. Superheated steam. Its unit is kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin. Now this in a problem, in a numerical, if it is not given, suppose it is not given, you can assume this as 2.1 kilojoules per kg degree Kelvin. It can be assumed. If it, in case it is not given, you can assume that value for Cp. Now T soup means temperature of superheated steam, that is the temperature up to which you are taking it. T sat is saturation temperature corresponding to the pressure at which we are heating the water. It can, its value, if you know the pressure, can be got from the steam table. And this T soup minus T sat, T soup minus T sat is called the degree of superheat. Degree of superheat. Now this can be directly given as degree of superheat, or they can give T soup separately, or T soup minus T sat can be given in a numerical. Now this are the stages, these are the stages, three stages in which heat is absorbed by water during conversion from water into steam. Now this can also be explained with the help of a graph drawn between temperature and enthalpy, or temperature and heat. It is called TH diagram. They can ask you to explain the formation of steam, explain the formation of steam with the help of TH diagram. Means it is a graph drawn between temperature and enthalpy. Always this is called TH diagram. T is always on the vertical axis, H is always on the horizontal axis. This is called enthalpy, this is called temperature. Now we take 1 kg water at 0 degree centigrade, that is 0 is here. As we give heat, as it, that water gets, takes heat, let us say we have taken 1 kg water at 0 degree centigrade and we are heating it at some constant pressure P1. Let us say the pressure is P1. Now as the water takes this this thing, its temperature continuously goes on increasing. When it has taken this much heat, this is its temperature. When it has taken this much heat, this is its temperature. So like that it has taken, and it has reached this point A, let us say. Now it starts evaporating, it starts boiling, the water starts boiling. Now what happens is, this is the corresponding T sat, saturation temperature corresponding to that pressure. And now what happens is, even if we are giving heat, the temperature will not increase, because here the process of evaporation is taking place and we get a horizontal line. So till here, let us say it is taking latent heat, that is both its pressure and temperature remain constant. So we have reached this point B. Then as we give heat, further heat, what happens is the temperature goes on increasing beyond saturation temperature. Now it is superheated steam. Now this is sensible heat, this is HF, This is sensible heat. This is latent heat, HFG. This heat which is given here, this is called the heat of superheat. So these are the stages in which heat is absorbed. Now this line OABC is called the constant pressure line, and this is pressure is P1. Now let us say we increase the pressure to P2 from P1. I have increased the pressure at P2. I have taken again 1 kg water at 0 degree centigrade. Now what happens is this A will move to A dash. It will move to A dash. It will be more now. The sensible heat is more, and here it will move to B dash. The latent heat has reduced. This is C dash. A dash, B dash. This is pressure P2 line. Next, if you take 1 more kg water from at 0 degree centigrade, and if you start heating it at a still higher pressure, now this A dash will move to A double dash, B dash will move to B double dash, and C dash. So this is P3 line. Now if I go on making like this, you go on getting it. And if I now join A dash, A double dash, A triple dash like that, these points, if I take this line and this line, are going to meet somewhere here. That is, this is the critical point. That is the critical temperature. Critical temperature. Now this line is called saturated liquid line. This line is called saturated liquid line. And this line passing through B, B dash, B double dash, etc. is called saturated vapor line. Saturated vapor line. Now where these two lines meet each other, that is the critical point. Here the latent heat goes on decreasing, and finally it becomes zero here. And this is the critical temperature, and the pressure corresponding to that is the critical pressure. So this sketch, they can ask you to write, explain the formation of steam with the help of TH diagram. Means you will have to draw this diagram and show it. These are called OABC, OA dash, B dash, C dash, OA double dash, B double dash, C double dash. They are called as the constant pressure lines here. So this diagram you will have to write and explain in case it is asked. If they ask you to explain the formation of steam with the help of TH diagram. Next, see here, next comes fifth one, the states of steam. States of steam. We have steam in three states. States of steam. Now there are three states of steam, three types of steam. They are called wet steam, then dry saturated steam, and superheated steam. Superheated steam, wet steam, dry steam or dry saturated steam, superheated steam. If you say simply dry steam also, it means dry saturated steam only. See, let us say I am forming steam at a pressure P1. Now I have given this sensible heat fully. The operation has started, and now at this somewhere here I stop giving the steam, the heat to the steam. Now if I stop here, it has taken sensible heat fully, but it has not taken the latent heat corresponding to it fully. Now if I stop giving heat at this particular point, now the steam that I have got is called as wet steam. This steam, anywhere between this line A and B, I have crossed this point A, that is the formation of steam has started, but the evaporation, the process of evaporation has not completed, then the steam which I have got, anywhere you stop it before reaching B, the steam which we have got is called as wet steam. So wet steam means it is a state of steam in which the evaporation is incomplete, it is having moisture, it is not a perfect gas, it doesn't obey the gas laws, it has absorbed sensible heat fully and latent heat partially. Such steam is called as wet steam. Now, if I give heat up to here, exactly up to B, I give full sensible heat and full latent heat. If I give both of them completely, then the steam that I got is called as the dry saturated steam, or it is called dry steam or saturated steam, anywhere you can call it. If I give heat beyond this, anywhere you can stop here, you can stop here, you can stop here, there is no standard point here, it can be stopped anywhere. Now, if you have given heat beyond the latent heat, that is, we have given more than this heat, anywhere you stop, then the steam which we have got is called as a superheated steam. Now, dry steam is in gaseous state, it is a perfect gas, it obeys the gas laws, there is no moisture in it, and it has absorbed both sensible heat and latent heat completely. This is again in gaseous state, it obeys the gas laws, it has absorbed sensible heat fully, latent heat fully, and it has also absorbed heat of superheat, and it is having, this has the lowest specific volume, this has greater specific volume than this when they are both at same pressure, and this has greater specific volume than this at the same pressure. So these are the differences between the different states of steam. You must know what is wet steam, what is dry steam, and what is superheated steam, and what are the differences between them. So these things you will have to know. So this is the fifth item. Then